Hi, welcome back to my workshop. Today we will continue on our CNC project. If this is your first video, I would suggest watching previous parts first to catch up with the build. Today we will finish the Y-axis assembly with the spindle. Let's start with the machining. For the plate that the spindle clamps to, I started with 20 mm thick aluminum. For the first operation, I wanted to have access to the upper flat as well as all the sides. I used superglue technique from NYC CNC, which you are probably familiar with. I glued painter's tape to the part as well as mill table for better adhesion. I firmly attached the tape with the help of a round dowel pin. Then I glued the part down with the superglue. I started the machining with fly cutter and cleaned the flat surface. I then cleaned the outer edges with the end mill. The work holding was exceptionally rigid, even with heavier side forces. The dimensions were not critical at all. But all the dimensions were very critical for the next operation. I decided to spot all the holes for mounting with spot drill. The holes were for attaching the blocks for the linear rail. Then I pried the part from the table with Allen key and the glue eventually gave up. I then drilled the holes on the drill press and repeated the super glue process for the other side. I used that technique because the clamps would be in the way on the top surface. After that was finished, I used the clamps with a pair of parallels to space the plate from the table and clamp it. I had to cut out and bore the hole for the spindle. I decided to roughly mark the circle for the hole and cut most of it out with the end mill, since that was much faster. The cutting went pretty smooth and I had mastered the simultaneous X and Y axis movement, especially at the end. For the next step, the hole needed to be finished with the boring operation to a close tolerance and diameter of 65 mm. I used a shopmate boring head. After some cuts, the tolerance of 1 or 2 hundredths of a millimeter was achieved. I measured it with the snap gauge and the fit with the spindle later confirmed the tight slip fit. I had to drill the holes for mounting the spindle clamps around the perimeter of the last hole. I had to reclamp the setup because that was few days after the previous operation. I found the center of the hole with the help of the edge finder. I first counterbored all the holes for the screw heads, then spotted all the holes which I later drilled on the drill press and tapped half of them for M6. The hole pattern was achieved with positioning on the previously calculated positions with a fixed diameter. I also had to modify the fixed bearing block for the ball screw. I did not want to tear apart the whole assembly, so I just clamped the bearing block in the vise and milled about 2 mm from one side for clearance. For attaching the cable connector for the spindle, I 3D printed the adapter to hold the connector. For the first time here. Of course, I put the wrong dimension for the spindle diameter instead of the clamp diameter. So we go for round 2, which fits perfectly. I decided to route the cables from the upper side and attach the cooling lines at the bottom, so any leak would result in just the dripping water and not the short circuit, hopefully. Here I had to do a final deburr of the clamps that had a lot of sharp corners. What follows is the final assembly of the axis with all the parts finished. The cable connector with the 3D printed mount would not function as intended, as you can see here, so the third time's a charm. I decided to mount it to the side of the axis so I would have access to it. But that meant I had to lengthen the cables and connect them to the connector. For the motor and ball screw mount, I only had to tap a few holes into the part of aluminum that fit perfectly and was from the 3D printer before it became CNC. I had to bore the inside diameter of the coupler for 14mm shaft of the NEMA 34 motor. I also had to machine the spacer for the ball screw nut. Here you can see the reason I had to mill about 2mm from the bearing block to get enough clearance. Everything went together nicely and the Y-axis is now finished. As you could see in the video, X-axis with the table could already be seen, so expect the next video soon. If you enjoyed the video, please like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one. We'll be right back.